fucking pissed.
And you're fucking loud. Okay, say something again.
Well, hello there.
Good enough. Video games.
For the best.
Mike, I got Wolfenstein for 75% off. Feels good, man. What would feel better, blowing you or Wolfenstein for 75% off?
Well, you do kind of have that, like, Popeye thing going on, so it depends on if you eat your spinach or not.
I wish I could do his laugh, like, or something like that. Dude, I wish.
One of these days, you're going to get really mad at me for calling you Popeye and just flip the fuck out.
Why would I call you get mad for that?
I don't know, but
I consider that a compliment anyways.
That's true.
I like Popeye.
He is the best.
Alright, so this is some game that Nightblade 1021 gifted me. And it cost him like almost $100. And Pat's like, yeah, you gotta play this. Like,
yeah, fine. Well, it's a good game, but dude, seriously, if you had waited till today, it's like $30 for the pack you got.
I get gifted games every few days, and it's like, it's kind of odd. Yeah, you really should have waited. I wonder if the Steam refunds thing works.
I think it would refund him the money.
Maybe I should just try it, just in case.
He's like, no.
No, I can't. Where would it be?
You have to go to the game in your library, Click on it, and then you have support under links on the side.
I should
From
try
there,
that.
You can do, like, refunds. And
Yeah, it's because they gifted it.
Okay.
This game apparently requires multiple product keys.
Which you never need, by the way.
Okay, so I'll just tell it not to show me that again. Whisper for you can do whispers on hitbox now. Sherpy told me how he's a top sniper. Like, is that really a thing? He totally goes. Yeah, I can whisper you.
Do what now?
I'm calling you a dum dum.
Who?
You.
Why?
Oh, apparently you disabled direct messages. Man, I need to learn how to do that.
Okay. I did? Where?
I don't know, but I'm envious of you.
I disabled direct messages on what?
Something. On Hitbox.
I didn't know that was even a thing.
You click someone's name to whisper them. It is a thing. Alright, let's go. Options. Quality level fastest. Now let's do good. I'm good.
Like, you gotta do fantastic. Come on.
No, I'm gonna do beautiful. I can't do fantastic because you want me to. And let me also put something underneath my microphone, so... some bullshit. Alright. It's apparently more difficult than I thought it would be. But I finally got it. Alright. No V-Sync, maximum frame count, 200. Okay. So everyone thank Nightblade for this. And I actually, to be perfectly honest, I didn't think I'd be starting this anytime soon. Just because I'm really lazy to reboot to Windows. There's like fucking 50 million updates to do when I got. That's how long it's been since I rebooted here, because I'm just like, yeah, fuck it. Dota works on Linux, so that's good enough. Alright, what are we doing? Okay, let's do a tutorial scenario. I'm doing a tutorial.
Oh god. Yeah, that'll probably be a good idea while we wait for Jason to finish his goddamn laundry.
Dude, when people whisper me, it actually shows up as a notification, because I have Firefox showing me notifications. And now that I said that, I'm now going to look for a way to turn that off before everybody figures it out.
Yeah, let me go look about that in my account and see if I can find that.
That's super fucking annoying.
Yeah, it's literally, as soon as you just click on your name at the top corner and then just go to account, it's right under notifications. Oh wait, no.
No, I don't want to turn off notifications. I like that. Like, you guys need to see this, actually. I'm gonna just fucking turn this, put this as a... Warning, area is enabled. Okay, go. Go send me messages. Just watch what happens while I'm playing the game, okay? Do it. Do it. It's also laggy when I'm capturing it like this. Whoa! Okay, that window's just decided to eat everything.
Mike, we can see your porn.
Yes, you can. Come on. I'm gonna do it. Someone message me something. Fuck it. Like, now that I'm actually showing it, nobody wants to message me anything. You guys are lame. There you go. This is what happens.
Apparently Nightblade messaged you.
He did a while ago. This is before I was actually showing it. There you go. Okay, now let me figure out how to turn it off, just because it's gonna piss me off. When did they add this?
I don't know.
I bet it's always been here.
I don't even know how to turn it off.
And Sherpie sexually identifies as a tech helicopter. Good to know. This is gonna be too annoying.
Okay, I can't actually link you GIFs.
Let me think here. See. Now I have to Google this stuff instead of playing games. See. Participate, you must sign into your account.
Oh, it's at the bottom of the thing, like in the actual chat. If you click on the three little dots that go up and down, you can turn whispers off.
Oh, there you go. They are off! They are off!
So turn it on and off.
Okay, that's what I just did. Okay, can you message me anything?
Nope, I can't. User has disabled direct messages.
Why would I have to switch it? Okay, whatever. Okay, now let's do video games. Alright, Toro Basics, sure. Splat. Alright, I must survive on this dangerous world. It reminds me of Civ 5.
It's going to. That's the whole point.
Okay. The bottom left is your army panel. Okay. It's only a single unit. Why is there three? So there gives... Okay, you can found a city. Alright, I can see three distances from position. Maybe I should just dive into this.
Yeah, that's what I attempted to do on the necrophage, and it ended all pretty well.
Okay, fine, let's do that then. How do I get out of this?
I think you just hit escape and you're good.
Alright, fine. We're gonna just play together then, I guess.
Yep.
Empire is 6. Difficulty, let's do easy, I guess. Since I've never... Well, no, let's do normal. Just because I'm hardcore. And how do I invite Patton?
You have to set it to a multiplayer match. Zero says session information mode single only, set it to friends only multiplayer.
Session information. Oh, there it is. Okay. I only want Pat to join, so. Nobody else better join, or else I'm gonna boot you.
I already joined, don't worry.
Okay.
I know how to abuse the system.
Okay. I just locked all the slots. Or no, I shouldn't lock yours. Alright, yeah, so yeah. I can either be Windrakers, a faction of creators and builders. They bind rocks.
Yeah, if you actually hit select Empire over on the side, you get a better information. You get better information.
God damn it, I want to be pink. Get off pink. Fuck you.
Okay, fine. I'll let you be pink.
No, actually, green is for Yoshis, so...
Okay, I'll be pink. Fucking okay. Go to the select Empire thing on the side to get more information. Just do
Fuck.
That.
A lot of shit here.
Yes.
Okay, so there's a faction of builders. That sounds boring. Expansion. Oh, so this is like Liberty? Yeah, Liberty and Tradition and... Oh, Wonder. So they go for Wonders.
Pretty much.
And there's a Science Woman.
She's got the Titas.
Yeah. You can't. I definitely want the Titas. I was about to say, are they all women? But then again, this guy has a beard, so I guess not. Science. Okay, let me actually read through this. This actually doesn't mean anything to me, so...
The traits at the bottom probably will give you more information than anything.
That definitely would. Holy resource. I want to be a godless heathen, though.
Yeah, well, they worship rocks.
Oh. It's a bug wearing a suit thing.
Yeah, they are my favorite.
Oh, they all have fucking... They're all the same. Oh, no. These two are the same.
Yeah, the Vaulters and the Mizari are just a reskin of the Vaulters.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. They were given to you because you bought that pack, quote-unquote.
I bought it, huh?
Yeah,
it used to be. And there's a floaty chairwoman. I want to be the floaty chairwoman.
Yeah, she is the master of mages. They're all pain berserkers.
Dude, magic as fuck. The painosphere. Dude, the painosphere.
Yeah, I know, right?
Dude, I want to make a painosphere now. Dude, it's like another kind of dungeon.
Look at their units too. Just like go through their units.
No, it's like another kind of dungeon. The painosphere. It's like send them to the painosphere for a couple days. Dude, that'd be so evil. All right, so yeah, they all have settlers. I understand this.
Yeah, but you get to look at what their warriors are.
Okay. And there's blazing wings. Okay, these people are kind of cool. But I like science too, so...
Their main victory type is science.
It's an evil kind of science.
Oh yeah, because it's like pain science, but it's still science.
It's like Queen of Pain.
She does kind of look like her.
It really does. Economy. So there's the... traders...
The first thing that they have under their traits is the best.
Nomadic cities.
Read what it does, asshole.
Gains full control of giant scarabs upon whose backs many tents of great caravan cities rest. The roving so they can move. You can move your cities.
Yes, at will and at any point you want.
That's funny.
For free.
That's great. And now it can be a lizard furry race.
You mean Yoshi?
Oh yeah, the Yoshis. Yeah, they're definitely Yoshis. Yeah, they literally are a Wavrin. Oh man, they could be fucking dragons. Alright, and then there's the weird three-armed people. Supremacy? What the fuck? What kind of victory is that?
That is the victory where you slap everyone with your dick.
This is kind of creepy, this guy.
Yeah, they're basically Venice.
They're fucking creepy. So they can only have one city or something? Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, you're right. That's kind of cool, actually. I have to say, I do kind of like the art of this game.
It's a very interesting style.
Okay. I guess I'll be the evil people.
The pain mages?
Evil science. Yes, pain mages. Fuck yeah. Alright, how do we be on a team?
You cannot.
Oh, so we're just against each other.
Yes, but we can form an alliance later on that will basically put us on the same team. And then we can also trade map information and stuff like that. It's actually a lot more in-depth than you think.
Yeah. Okay, so everything else looks good here?
Yeah.
Pangea.
You can set that however you want.
I like large Pangea, or maybe large islands. Or maybe like many continents. Yeah, let's do many continents. Irregular, disturbed, chaotic.
Mouse over them and it'll give you more information on them.
Yeah, no, I've been realizing that's a theme.
Some of them are actually kind of snarky. Which always amuses me.
Yeah. Okay, I'll just make it relatively average. Let's not do anything strange. Alright, I think we're good?
Yeah, we're pretty much good to go.
Okay. Ready.
He's still not done with his damn laundry. How much fucking clothes does he wear?
Who? Oh.
Jason.
Jason. Has a new job. He has no idea. There is no job. All right, so we're launching game. Okay, let's see how long it takes for me to load a post to Pat. Pat, how good is your computer?
Well, as I learned with Jason, it's actually really good. Oh, it's okay. Amazing, even. Oh. I'm so happy you don't even know. Fucking 7 fans and liquid cooling. Hey, I can't go wrong.
I guess that means Mike Ladd is a scaly. Fucking scalies. Fucking weird people. The internet has ruined me forever.
They are weak. They are soft. They writhe in supposed discomfort at minor penances that the faithful would not even notice. Their sloth will be their undoing. Without the pain, they cannot touch the power. Use your eyes, or I will remove them in atonement. See that Auriga herself writhes in anguish, as we all should. Join me in contrition and mortification, such as Auriga has never seen. Together, we will embrace the agony and make it our servant.
The flying fuck is with these people. Alright. I have encountered a new minor faction, Suriton. Okay. Arachnid centaurs.
Dude, look at their tits.
That's okay. Assimilation effects. Peace be to Argyr and to you. May our conversations be civil and frequent.
Okay, let me explain something about the dragons. They know exactly where you are already. That's their bonus.
Dude, I'm having a fucking cold war right now.
Yeah, you're in a cold war with all other factions.
That's hilarious. Okay. I don't want to talk to that guy. My god, it's telling me all this shit and I have no idea what's going on.
It's just saying that you got the DLCs and shit.
Okay. So what's this guy? I have a...
Okay.
I have a thing.
Guys in the chat, is it just me or does Mike's stream look really gray?
No, this game is just gray.
Mine's not.
Yeah, maybe I'll just fuck around with the settings then.
Yeah, your game looks like shit. What the fuck?
It's supposed to be beautiful, though.
Yeah, no. Fucking set up the post-processing to high. Like, fucking knock these graphics up, bitch.
It's still gray. What do you want me to do?
I don't know. I mean, just everything looks like it has a gray filter over it.
The fuck do you want me to do?
I don't know. I just don't know if it's me or not.
It probably is, Pat. It's your fucking fault. Oh, wait. Empire's color... okay?
No, like...
It's color palette, no.
I have all the settings set to max.
I don't know what to fucking do.
I mean, just even, like, your menu and stuff has a gray filter over it.
Oh god, it's gray. Well, it could be my video card. What the fuck even just happened? Okay. Apparently I destroyed my city. It's gone.
It's down there in Graldane.
Why did it go here? I have no idea how to scroll the minimap.
Just click and drag, or use WASD.
WASD is the only thing I can do. This is slightly less gray, maybe? I mean, I'm pretty sure this is maybe related to the fact I just updated my graphics card drivers and I kind of didn't reboot.
That could be it.
I don't know, does anybody really care?
No. I just thought something had happened to the stream. It's what?
I really can't click and drag, though. I have to use WASD. Is that
that's,
really?
That's not normal. I can click and drag just fine.
What the fuck? This is kind of weird. Okay, let me restart the game.
Okay.
I don't know if this saves it, but...
Nope.
Okay, well, fuck it.
I didn't have enough time to say anything.
Well, does it really matter?
No, because we didn't do anything yet, except watch the goddamn cutscene.
Alright.
I guess you could say Mike made a grave mistake.
I've read the joke, Pat. God damn it. See, it doesn't look so grayish right now.
I know, but I like to say it because I get to do that.
Okay, come on in. Come on in again.
I think I'm still in your room.
No, you're not. I mean, it saved all my other stuff. I don't know why it takes like a second for me to...
Thank you, Mortai.
...to lock the slots, but whatever. Okay, I think... Yeah, many continents. Alright, let's try this again. Ready up, Pat?
Okay.
Why are people saying rip?
No, I think because the stream crashed just temporarily.
Oh.
Because it went all black.
Yeah, I noticed that it... Oh, no, it didn't crash. It was just the game stopped, so...
Okay.
I'm still here.
We can only hope.
Exploiting the terrain can be critical to your success. Choose a position of your city carefully. It didn't even let me choose a position of my city,
because
though.
Because you didn't put your city... You didn't build your city yet.
Oh, because I saw some sort of fucking landmark nearby.
Yeah, that wasn't your city. That was a ruin.
Oh.
Oh, there's ruins in this game, by the way.
Okay, what do they do?
They can give you dust, quests, resources. They can do all sorts of random shit. I think there's like 30 or 40 different things you can get from them.
Waiting for other players, Pat.
Fuck you. It says I'm ready on my screen.
Okay, I'm just going to skip past this. Okay, this looks maybe a little bit better. Okay, maybe. Oh, there we go. I can use the mouse thing to scroll now.
Yeah. Okay. Good.
Unspoiled ruins.
Okay. So, let me point out a few things. If you click on your main unit, you're going to have at the bottom, starting from left to right, you have your hero in that group, then the actions you can do, and all the units that are currently in that group. Do you see that?
Oh. They just kind of stack it on top of each other.
Yeah, and you can actually click on each individual one and use the transfer action to move them out of the group, if you so wish.
Okay, transfer. Oh, to a nearby army, or creates a new army on an empty tile, I see.
Yes.
Okay, so, first of all, I have unspoiled runes here. Okay, so what am I trying to do in the early game here?
Here at the beginning, you kind of want to explore out and put down your town somewhere in your territory that you start at.
Okay. So I guess I want to split up these soldiers and make them move into different places.
Yeah, kind of explore out and try to find a pretty decent spot to land on.
Yeah, I don't really know what would be a decent spot, though. I'm a pain specialist.
Well, when you go to click, it won't set your city down on the exact spot you are. Just click the set, the place city button, and it'll give you a bit of information on your surroundings.
Just click it?
Yes, just click the little capital button.
Okay. Oh, I see. Total output. Food and gears is, I guess, production.
Yeah, and then you get your food, your production, your science, and gold.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So it gives you a lot of information very readily so that you aren't just left in the dust, like, what the fuck is going to happen here,
I think I want to do here, but I have low production. I don't know. What do you guys think? Is this a good place? What do you guys think? Or should I just keep looking around? I'll look around a little bit. Alright, no more movements. So this is a... I don't know what the fuck this is.
Don't build it close to the border of a territory either. Like, you see those little white borders? Don't build them close to that. That is my only suggestion to you.
Okay. Because it would give me a lot of science if I went there.
Yeah, but you can expand out in that direction.
Oh.
The actual borders of those territories are actually just that. They are borders, and they will actually keep you from expanding in those directions.
Oh, I see. Oh, that's a nice place right here. So you don't have to necessarily go right away. This is a coastal line. Holy shit. So how about a coastal... Is this like Civ 5 where the coastal cities are like really fucking nice?
Well, also later on you can expand out into there. So you don't have to build a coastal city. In fact, I don't think I ever have.
Okay.
So
it's... There's no point in like going on a tile that has like high outputs of stuff? Or is there,
it is very beneficial to get a high output, but don't put it direct. I mean, putting it directly on the ocean is not necessarily a bad thing, but it won't benefit you just directly because you can expand out to the ocean.
Okay, well, I'll leave it like this for now. Okay, I'm getting the turn.
Okay.
I mean, the graphics are kind of pretty.
Yeah, it looks nice.
Booster effect. Something on cities, something on cities. So, what's the deal with these white lines?
Those are territories. That's like the territory lines.
Yeah, but it's in a giant circle around me.
Yes, because that's actually the area that it is. When you build a town, you don't just build town, like multiple towns kind of close together in this game. When you build a town in an area, you own that territory. You own all the stuff in that white line.
Okay. I guess I'll go to this thing that I saw.
But building your town is actually a good thing, so I will try to do it within the first one or two turns.
Yeah, I just made it. Goddamn, Pat.
Yeah, and you will probably notice that the fucking colors of the borders changed.
Ah, it's green now.
No.
Uh-huh. Alright, so... no idea how to build anything. Holy fuck, there's so many screens. Fucking hell.
Yeah, you're basically learning all over again.
Guys, you want me to just, like, turn on my text editor and write some code? Because I think it'd be, like, the same experience. It's so complicated.
Okay. Let me say this. Starting from the top...
Holy shitballs, what are you making me do? Maybe I should have done the tutorial. What the fuck is this?
Do you see up at the top where it shows you like your production of like food production?
This isn't a research tree, it's a research fucking circles.
Yes, and you have to research so much in each circle to go to the next one.
Fucking Christ.
This game is a lot more in-depth than Civ 5 is.
Yeah, you think?
But it's not a bad thing. Right?
No, I guess not, but holy shit.
Okay, a few things about the science thing. Anything that's colored blue is something you already own. Anything that's yellow is specific to your civilization.
How do I increase pain?
You have to become Bane.
Okay. Alright, what's important to me right now?
Well, it depends on where you started at. If you're low in food, maybe getting something that gives you early food is good. Okay, if you started with low production, you know, whatever.
Maybe I'll do food. Except I have no idea how.
Well, you already started building your basic monument thing, right? The foundation memorial.
Is that shit food? Is that like the fucking...
Yeah, the little food symbol.
Yeah, the little food symbol. It looks like wheat, kind of.
Yeah.
It's like three dicks kind of a thing.
God damn it.
All right. So one of those. Yeah, I'll do that then. I guess that's researching.
Yeah, when you click, and you can click on multiple ones to research in a row too.
Yeah, I know. I assume that. Okay, so I'm researching two things. And fucking list of quests, manage my heroes. Where are my heroes? And it's a floaty woman with a staff. Okay. Okay, so floaty woman with a staff is going to be there. Fuck, how do I build shit?
Like in your town?
Yes.
Just click on your town. Like, click on the name of your town.
Okay, Oh, that, okay.
Yeah.
Oh my god, there's so much to this fucking game.
Maybe. Yeah, okay, first off, do you see up at the top where it has, like, your food, your production, your science, your money, and then that little star?
Yeah.
You see that little orange person?
Yes.
That is your first citizen in your town. You don't manage your citizens like in Civ 5 by selecting tiles for them to work on. You select them to work in a general production sense. You can move him around to switch him to like production or science or something else. And as you get more of them, you can spread them out in any way you see fit. You could pick up the little orange guy and take him from food and put him into production if you wanted, or science.
I think I want him in food, though.
Well, yeah, you probably do. And you even have a thing just to the side of there where it shows you how many turns it's going to take for you to get another citizen. It's going to be 5 turns.
Okay. Holy fuck, man. So much. Alright, what am I building then? One-time construction creates a memorial to your leadership.
It's basically like your, Yeah, what were they called in Civ 5?
I could raise the city. I give up
Yeah, you could actually lose the game right now and raise your city.
Awesome.
I did that once. It's a bad idea.
Okay, so why can't I build this yet? Oh, because they require food and stuff.
Okay, the borough streets, you can only build. It requires 2 citizens for every one that you build.
Okay, so I guess I'm going to build the Founders Memorial then.
Yeah.
Okay, and I guess we're done. Is there anything else I need to do?
Did you do your science?
Yes.
Did you set your units to explore and walk around and find new shit?
Oh. Fine, I'll set them to explore, auto-explore.
Yeah, auto-explore in this game works differently. They'll only automatically explore the territory they're in. You have to actually manually explore with them.
Yeah, but isn't my territory, you said, like over here.
It is now, but they'd have to be in that territory over there to auto-explore it.
Oh. Okay, well, they're done moving around, so... Okay, I guess I'm done.
I think your hero's also still in your town, too.
Oh, do I not want him to be in the town?
Well, there's a couple different things you can do with your hero. You can send him out with your other armies and fight with them, or you can set them to be the governor of your town. In the bottom left corner, click on the portrait of your hero.
Okay.
And that'll bring up some more information on
them. Oh my fucking god.
You can equip them with all sorts of armor and weapons. How much
fucking management is there?
And they have their own skill tree. Click the skill tree.
Do I, like, is this like The Sims? Do I, like, make them go to sleep and pee and stuff?
You can actually send them to sleep.
Fucking hell. Okay, so what now? When am I clicking?
You can go to their skill tree. And that's where you can decide as they level up if you want them to be more war-orientated. Or you can get boosts to your governorship with them so that they will give your town more science and stuff like that.
Pain science. Okay, but I can't. They don't have any skill points, so I can't do anything. Alright, well.
Yeah, I just wanted to show you where that is so you know that it's there.
Fucking this. This is really, really complicated, though. It's gonna take a while to learn.
Yeah, but isn't that, like, the greatest part?
I suppose.
I love shit like this. You don't even know. Okay. You probably do know.
I just got a quest. Try to bring your followers and the faithful after events of your brother's death. Parley with at least 2 villages. the fuck is, what the hell is this? Okay, I got a quest for something.
Yes, this game has quests.
Yeah, no, I know that, I know that. Use the research screen to unlock the language square. Oh. Apparently I need to unlock language.
Yeah, it's a science. Yeah, it's a science. It's at the bottom. It's called Language Square, and it allows you to talk to the minor factions, like those Saritan you found. You can talk to them, get quests from them, or you can just piss them off and fight them. Your choice.
Oh. What? Okay. Apparently, I don't have to hold shift. It just kind of deselects things. Okay, I'm gonna try and finish this thing first. How long is it gonna take, though?
It should tell you. At the bottom of the screen.
No, one more turn.
Yeah, the actual spot you started in has really, really crazy high science.
Yeah, I know. That's the point. I'm gonna get so far ahead, Pat. I encountered a new minor faction, the Delvers. Okay. They
AKA Dwarfs.
They look like, yeah, Dwarf Fortress and shit.
Don't even know.
Okay, so I guess with my hero, I'll just make him manage the town or something.
Yeah. But remember, you can't send him out to your military again and for 5 more turns after you set him to governor. Got my cooldown.
Sure. Okay, how do I make him governor?
Go to your city, click on it, and then you have
assigned the hero. Thing. Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Automate.
You can even set it. Yeah, you can set him to automate, and your hero will specifically choose upgrades, citizen management, and stuff like that for you. I've never used it, so I don't know how good it actually is. I'll be perfectly honest with you.
Apparently, he can automate one thing. City development will balance between possible improvements. Automate construction to generate more production. Okay, I'll just leave it. Mike and Starkov spam tanks and turtled. But fuck you. I did Zerg rushes and shit. Alright, let's just continue then. So I can bring the hero also to go and investigate ruins, I'm guessing?
Yeah, but your regular units can do that on their own.
Oh, I see. Alchemist Furnace. Oh, yeah. And this is the thing that gives me more food. Okay. When performed by a hero, this action provides a base value of 10 experience. Whatever, just do it. Okay. Holy shit. Build 2 extractors exploiting one or more of the following luxuries. Rewarded. Augmented extractor. Okay, so when do we start, like, doing pain-related shit?
As soon as you start getting further in your quests.
Oh, there's a lot of shit here. These guys walk around like there's something up their butt.
There probably is.
You know, sad thing is, you're probably right.
I don't know how Mike's gonna feel about when he learns that he's gonna have to start equipping his troops with armor and shit.
I don't know, it's probably a heavy micromanagement.
It's not as much as you'd think. It's just occasionally you will have to do specific things.
Okay. I got 30 dust, alright.
Woohoo!
Now we can
dust
detect,
is money.
Now we can detect bounty hunter and shit. No, well, no, we can
Ricky.
Detect Ricky. Okay, fine, Ricky.
Fuck Ricky.
Yeah, everyone hates Ricky.
That's very true.
Science is nice. Okay, I got the language thing. So, conversations. Unlocks army action. Parley on empire. Bribe on empire. Okay, so parley is what now?
Parley means you talk to them. So if you would go up to one of the little minor factions, like the Keratin, and initiate an action with them, you can now talk to them and get quests from them. And or just, you know, piss
them off.
This
motherfucker's hostile. Okay, I'm going to talk to him. Oh, apparently they're not hostile. To pacify the Hunter's emboldenment, donate some luxuries and draw crowds of merchants. Gift 10 die to the new public market of Honduras. Wow. Okay, so they just gave me a useless quest.
Yeah, they want you to get 10 die and give it to them, basically.
What a bunch of assholes. Okay, so where can I see my quests?
It should be the little up at the top.
I see. Okay, so... where's the thing I have to talk to people?
What do you mean?
I just had a quest to... oh, here we go. Parlay with at least two villagers. Oh, there we go. So I do have it. It goes 0 out of 2, but then it goes 1 out of 2.
Yeah, because it's the actual quest and then the progress on your quest.
I see. Oh, okay, apparently I clicked and it didn't click. Oh wait, I forgot to do more research. Whoops.
Well, at least it's not going to let you go without doing that, right?
No, it did. It went without letting me do that.
Well, probably because you kept spamming the enter button.
Okay. More science. More science! I don't know. I think I need food, though. Advanced alloys.
Yeah, those allow you to get new weapons and armor to equip to your units and your hero.
Doing fucking science. Can't stop me, Pat.
How you doing, Sully?
Hey, Sully.
He did say hi to you, Mike. He said hi to me. Get the fuck away.
Aww. Sully's mine. Unlocks tier 1 something balls.
Balls?
Yeah. Unlocks balls.
Oh, I love balls.
Exactly. Okay. Okay, I'm trying to parlay about my brother's death. Why did my brother die? Why is he a fucking dick? He's no brother of mine.
Well, not yet, he's not.
Can you talk to this asshole? Why am I not talking to him?
Because he's down on the cliff below you.
Really? Can't he just yell?
Just move over one and talk to him.
I'm trying to, but apparently I'm still not on the same level as him.
You look. There's a button in the in your actions thing that will allow you to talk. Click on the unit.
Oh, really? That's what you have to do? Wow. Wow. Okay, so I just got 15 titanium. There are rumors of rogue troops nearby. Go explore the ruins marked by rays of dust.
Okay, I'm gonna stop you here because you're about to get fucked in the ass. Can I say that?
Okay.
You are. Fucking get your units together before you go to fight that.
Okay.
This happened to Jason, and it's what fucking caused him to rage out of the game. He's like, it's only goddamn turn 10! Why the fuck did you send that much shit at me? God! So, you better prepare for this one. Let me just stop you.
Apparently I have to give them 100 dust. How much dust do I have? I apparently have 100 dust, though.
You have 178.
Yeah, so... but why would I want to give them this dust, though?
Because it'll pacify them and make them no longer attack you. They're basically barbarians that you can get bonuses from.
Can't I just kill them?
You can. But that could be very difficult, considering you only have one unit there and they have two.
Okay, fine. I'll give them money. I don't give them money.
Parlay with them again and bribe them.
Okay, I just want to try it. Oh, that's it?
Yeah, now they won't attack you.
Okay, they're gonna be bros now?
Oh no, they want you to do something else.
Do they really?
Yeah.
You please the Delvers who told you what you actually need to do. Bring a hero with 10 titanium to the other Delver's village located in the same region.
So you need to explore that area more. And you have 15 titanium just from searching ruins, but... okay. You have to go find the other Delver group there.
But the hero has to bring it, so...
yes.
He's still locked for one more turn.
Triple strike.
Mike, don't give the money.
I said the same thing, he just wants to learn.
Why would I not give the money? I'm a nice guy.
Very true, Mike is the best.
Actually, wait. You can go up here.
Mike's no crumb bum.
Research complete. Yay. Alright, let me unassign this guy. Okay. Is this still building? Yeah, it's still building a Founders Memorial. Where's my guy? Where's my hero?
Probably in your town.
Is he? No, he's not. I think it said something about returning him to the academy.
Oh, you can assign him now. Like, if you click on your little military... Yeah,
he still exists. Where is it? Where the fuck is he, though?
Click on your actual military unit that you want to assign him to, and then you can assign him there.
The fuck are you talking about?
Click on a fucking group of your military units.
Oh, he has to be assigned to that?
Yes. He can be, and he can just appear there. He doesn't actually have to be near your town either.
Okay. What the hell's this? Die deposit, alright. Yay, dust.
Woohoo.
This game is very complicated.
Well, it's got a lot of depth, which is good. Just what you need in these kind of games.
Okay, my city doesn't appear to be expanding very much.
Because its borders don't expand manually.
Okay.
Or on their automatically. You have to expand them by researching the district bureaus.
Apparently now I can only move twice, because I have the hero with that group.
Yeah, certain... You're basically limited to the movement points of the slowest person in a group. That's which I guess lame. Is your hero.
Lame.
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, I just got an achievement for some reason. Oh god, achievements. Alright.
Isn't that what we play video games for?
Metagaming. Alright, now let me go talk to this motherfucker, and I can't. What? Why can't I talk to this guy?
I don't know, why does it say?
It says I've already got a quest from this guy, but this is his other base. He said give me my shit.
You have to gift them, I think.
The fuck? Oh, here you go, gift. What the fuck just happened? Oh, okay. It's pacified now.
Yeah, now they won't randomly attack you.
Okay. But I didn't actually give them anything. Like, I still have the 15 titanium.
Yeah, you were just supposed to have the titanium, I think.
Oh. What a bunch of scrubs. Minor faction, Sisters of Mercy. Okay. Let's go talk to them.
Bitches, some big ass arms. I'm just saying.
So that you can effectively lead and integrate other peoples by coming into the village with a diverse army? Wow. All I need is units. That's kind of neat.
Yeah, minor faction units.
Okay. Which means?
To be honest, I don't actually know how to do that.
Okay.
I've not played the game as much as I have wanted to.
We're not doing pain science. three more turns on this guy. Let's see what else I want to do. There's so much fucking shit here. Oh yeah, I'm doing that one after. You have to pacify the minor faction and colonize the territory with the, what the fuck? Then you can recruit your unit.
No, yeah, that's how you do it. I forgot about that, because then you can build them in your town afterwards.
Okay, I guess I should split these guys off. Garrison. Oh, apparently I can't. The hero's just permanently a part of this.
Yeah, he is on top of that, yeah.
I kind of wanted to bring him back home, but he just kind of teleports wherever.
Yes.
I should really unassign him. Oh, he's locked to it. Again.
Yeah, he can only move every so many turns.
Yeah.
Hey, and you're about to find Orange.
Who the hell is Orange?
I don't know. Nobody knows.
What the hell? I just got a message. Oh. I just got a message. I have no idea what that
means. Bottom right corner. You see where that plus button is?
I have not activated a pillar.
Okay, go to your main town. This is something specific to your fucking people. Go to your main town. Up in the top left corner, do you see those two, like, little buttons below your money? Below your money.
Oh, yeah, I see. Pillar of Knowledge or Pillar of Speed. Dust magic around this pillar grants mages an extra fleetness of foot, reducing movement costs. Okay, so I can either go really fast, or I can science. Fucking science. And where do I make this?
Yeah, but remember, those cost, dust, but yeah.
So pillar range 1, so I just have to make it beside my town?
Yep.
Dude, no, we're doing fucking science. I love science. And that's it? It's just there forever?
No, it has a set duration. I think like 10 turns.
Oh, that's lame. But why would it be like, oh, you need to fucking use pillars?
Because pillars are a big part of your actual nation.
Fuck pillars. I'm not using pillars ever again. I'm just kidding. I'll use pillars all the time. So, to say that there's a lot to this game would be an understatement.
Yes.
Actually, wait, I didn't make this guy go anywhere. Actually, let me go here. So, is there, like, no map of the world I can just see?
Just zoom out.
Research complete. Good man. A new empire plan will be unlocked in 6 turns. Save some influence points if you intend to implement crucial policies. This stuff.
Yeah, social policies, it's the stars. You have to re-up those every so often, but they do give you pretty neat boosts for their duration, at least.
So much to this.
Are you not entertained?
Where in the flying fuck is the policies?
Okay. First button up at the top, you have that wreath, right?
Yeah.
Then you have Empire Plan. It's the middle, bottom, big fucking circle thing.
What?
The wreath, you tard. Not the goddamn capital thing.
Yeah, okay, I'm at the wreath.
Yeah, do you see Empire Plan?
My god, it's like a submenu.
Yes. It simulates.
Apparently this is important. This isn't important enough. It has to be some small buttons on some fucking...
It simulates, and that'll show you how much influence points it's gonna cost.
Holy shit. More science. Alright. I can unassign the hero now.
Yes.
So they always go back to the academy. I can't make him just explore on his own.
No.
It's kind of
shitty. As far as I know, you can't.
Okay, well. You like this music? Well.
Mike, are you about to be an asshole?
No. Alright, well, okay, alright. So, should I unassign the hero or what?
I mean, that's entirely up to you. You're gonna have to figure out how you want to play this, Mike.
Well, how do you get more experience to your hero?
By having him go out and do shit.
Okay. Come back and search this ruin with a Delver's unit in your army and a minimum of 10 titanium and 10 glass steel. And I get Valiant Lightning, which is apparently a crossbow. Holy shit. Dude, railguns. This guy's railguns.
He's offering you the railgun.
I like this guy. We have to get the railguns. Okay, so, but how do I have a Delver's unit then? Like, didn't
you...
I...
What?
I pacified them, so do I just ask one of them to be my bros or something?
Pretty much. You just have to build a town over in that area where you pacify them, and then you can build Delver units in that area.
Okay. Is there any reason I wouldn't want to build another town right now?
Well, building a town removes a citizen from your wherever you built it.
Oh, I see.
So, if you're low on citizens, then it is maybe a bad idea, but
I just met the creepy faceless people.
Oh, good. They only have one town, so at least you'll always know where they're at.
Declaration of war? Oh, apparently this costs the influence.
Yeah, you can't actually just trade freely in this game. It costs those stars.
Oh.
You can compliment the mic.
Can I? But that yeah. costs stars.
Yeah.
Why would I want to pay stars for
this? But it
makes
them feel good about themselves.
I don't fuck them. Dude, what would you say if, like the fucking people, like, the race of pain came up to you and complimented you?
I'd be like, damn, that's awesome. Yeah. I'd be okay with it.
You just buy another citizen with dust? Really? Apparently I can buy citizens.
You can?
Yeah, I have 3 citizens right now, so let me make one of them into another city. How do I make him do that? How do I make him into a city?
Did you buy a settler?
No. I'm trying to make one into a city.
You create a settler. It's a fucking unit, like that, like a building, basically, but it's a unit.
Oh, here we go. Settler. Holy shit, it's gonna take 30? What the fuck? Why?
Well, it's going to take more time after the other one's done. You also have really low production in your city. You have 4 production.
How do I get more production? Dude, shit sucks ass.
You can move citizens into production, and that'll make stuff get built faster.
That's probably a better idea.
There's also one of the science things you can build. It's called the Mill Foundry, which gives you 6 production and 15% increased production on the city.
Sorry, Nilf what?
Mill production.
What about mill production?
Or Mill Foundry.
Where is this?
It's a science thing. It's like the glowing hot magma bucket. In your science menu, Mike.
Yeah, I'm fucking looking. Okay, I see. Okay. I'll do that next. Because this one's actually... No, fuck that one. You do that one now. Fucking science. Alright. Pay dust to speed it up to end one turn. Pay dust for what? Like...
One of, like... Just... You can use... Okay, you know how in Civ 5 you can actually buy a building if you have enough money?
Yeah.
Well, in this game you can do that. But you can also let it be produced a certain amount and then buy it out for like a percentage, a vast percentage less.
Oh, but I if see. You're,
yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I see the button for that. Oh my god, there's so goddamn much to this. Alright, I guess I should make him the governor again.
Maybe. Let's
make him the governor. Get some sexy armor for governing. And there's some more units there. I really think I should have done the tutorial, to be honest.
Yeah, do you want to maybe save this and go do that now?
I think I'll do it on my own time.
Okay, well, I would have been interested in helping you get through it, but that's fine. That's okay.
Well, having fun is questionable because I don't understand it.
Oh, so you're not having fun?
Well, I'm spending my time learning it, basically. I mean, it's an interesting game. Don't get me wrong.
Oh, yeah.
I just don't get it, though.
That's not a bad thing, though. It just takes time.
Dust. So can everyone only do the ruins, like, once or what?
Nope. The ruins are... Everybody can use the ruins.
Oh, okay. Let's go do it now. I don't know. I'd have to spend a lot of time doing that.
Mike, everybody in the chat loves you. What do you not understand about that? Nobody will be mad at you.
So much this fucking game. We could try another one, like Endless Space or something else.
That's more of a roguelike, though.
Oh, hey, look, it's, a battle with the first hand of queen is about to begin.
Yep, you were in their territory, and they're kind of pissed about that.
Yeah.
So, good luck. You're about to learn about combat in this game. I would suggest, you know, not autoing it, because that's bad.
Yeah, I think I'm about to die. Or I can retreat.
And you can do that as well, and then get the fuck out of their territory.
And the space is a space-save game.
Oh, Dungeons of the Endless is the roguelike. My bad.
That's what it was a roguelike.
One of them's a roguelike.
Yeah, I guess I'll just fight just so I know what the combat's like. Adjust your troops' deployment on the battlefield. Alright.
He's got his hero there, too. Remember, if you look up at the top, it shows you the order that everybody's going to move into, so...
Wow, I'm so fucked. How do I run away?
You can't now. You gave up your chance to run away.
No! Run away! Wait, what the fuck? All my units are just doing things automatically.
Yes. You select the general thing for them to do, and then they do it.
Oh.
Now you can select your units to attack that guy that's moving towards you. You can click them, then right-click on him, because currently they're just... You've got them set to chickens with their head cut off mode. You have to right-click, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And he's, coming to the middle of us. Haha, we have him cornered. And he just totally wrecked my scouts. Haha, eat that.
Yeah, that's their hero, too.
I'm wrecking him, too. Kick his ass.
By the way, your people are berserkers. The lower health they're at, the more damage they do.
Of course, because we're pain science.
Exactly.
And he's ranging me like a bitch. I think these guys are dead. All right, I think I'm done with this now. I'm gonna do the tutorial, I think.
Alright, that's probably a good idea.
Too much to fucking learn all in one go, man.
Well, you're the one who started and were like, nah, I got this shit.
No, I asked you and you said, no, I'm not, I didn't need it or anything like that.
Well, I did, but Then again, I played as a pretty simple people on my first go, so...
You're dumb, that's why.
Oh, well, fuck you too.
Endless Space isn't even downloaded anyways, and that would be another complicated game to start up anyways. Fucking hell. It's just too much to learn all in one go, man.
I actually wouldn't mind watching either Nightblade and KG.
What are you talking about?
They're like, they want to watch you do the tutorial. They're pretty gung-ho about it.
You really want me to go through this tutorial right now? Alright, I guess I can. Apparently I got a new gift or something. What the hell is this? No, one new item in my inventory. Oh, I think it's like a card for just playing this game.
Probably.
Alright, let's start the game tutorial. You can learn with me. Okay, fine. Because it's too
learning much. With Mike.
It's too much to just do it right on the go. All right, Endless Legend. Okay. Dangerous World. No. Click my army by left clicking. Bottom left is the panel. Okay. Your army is comprised of a single unit. Your army can see a distance of 3 tiles from its position. You can zoom in and out for better view. Okay, yeah, we know about that. That's life, movement, vision range. Okay. It costs 1 movement point to traverse most terrain, however, some tiles like forest can cost more. Okay. Each region has a fixed frontier and can only contain once a single city. Oh wait, you can only make one city?
With the settler, yes. In a region.
So the borders...
That's why those regions are important.
So those borders, where you put the city, like you can only have one city in that entire thing?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't know that.
I told you that earlier, but I guess that does kind of get pushed to the wayside.
Okay. Terrain resources are food, industry, science, and dust. To help you decide, you can click the display. Wait, what? There's a button right here that tells me this. Well, Pat, you didn't tell me this? God, you're fucking the worst.
Yeah, I kind of forgot about it. Dude, there's a lot to fucking say, okay?
For most of the major factions, it's best to select a location that gives access to these terrain resources and surrounding exploration tiles. To found a city and colonize reasons, select your army. And left click on colonization action and then click again on the tile. Okay, so I'm thinking this thing here. Do I want production or do I want science? Okay, well, let's see. Well, let's just do production. I mean, this only takes one turn as well. Select your city by left clicking on the city center or one of the 6 surrounding tiles that compose it. Okay. You now rule over an entire region. This is your city interface. Your city center plus the 6 tiles surrounding it will collect every turn their terrain resources. Oh! So it's not just about the one you start on, it's about the ones around it.
It's too. About what's around you, yeah.
Fucking Pat never explaining shit to me. Fuck Pat.
God damn it, Mike. I tried.
Fucking Pat, honestly. God.
No!
The city center, as a city district tile, automatically modifies the initial train income, providing more dust and science. But less food. Okay. Worker panels, all the things scheduled for one turn. Wow, okay, so this is like the kind of stuff like I wouldn't know if I hadn't gone through the tutorial because Pat's useless and doesn't tell me shit. God damn it. This is much more helpful than Pat. I'm just going to keep ragging on Pat for the rest of this.
Yeah, I know. It makes me happy, don't worry.
Okay, per worker production, resources from tiles and potential modifiers probably will have an impact on total production you can expect from your city next turn. Alright, so... City Hall from tile. Plus one from. So when it's like. Plus 32 from. It's 3.2 from happy. Oh, so when they're happy, they produce more. That motherfucker. Okay. You can move a worker from one column to the next in order to determine which FIDSI production you want to boost for the next turn. Alright.
Bitsy.
Production cannot be stored. Excess food is automatically used every turn to produce additional workers. Neat. The green part of the population thing shows you're about to gain additional in the next turn. Cool. Industry production cannot be stored in your city. It should be used to connect new city improvements. Yeah, okay, I understand that. Or else it'll disappear next turn. List of available construction zones. Okay, so Founders Memorial is available. We know that. It can only be built once per city. Okay. Like many, you can get details. This is gonna take 4 turns instead of the 15 that it was taking me last time. Fucking hell.
Yeah, because you had no reduction in your city. And I told you that. I said, dude, you have really
high
science
and gold. You told me that after. You told me that after.
No, I told you, you have really high science and gold, but your production's low. That's all you need to build the mill foundry.
I don't know what the fuck I'm doing, Pat.
Okay.
The construction at the top of the queue will show prediction. Okay, we know that. You need to develop your science to get an edge on every empires. Okay. You want to keep researching new technologies if you don't want to waste your science. Yes. Okay. Yeah, we know this thing. First of only 6. Oh, so there's only 6 technology eras. You must research 9 new technologies from the previous era. Okay. This cost in science automatically increases for each new technology research. In addition, researching more advanced era costs more science. Alright. So technologies. Rough.
Fuck off, dogs.
Directly unlock new powers or bonuses for your empire, while others unlock city improvements. Units or that can be built. Blue circled. Okay, so apparently blue circled are already known. Green are unknown. And several technologies can be selected in a row. They will be researched one after the other. Okay. Food and industry technology are usually a safe way to begin using your science. You can hover over each technology to learn its effects. Okay, so let's say this is a city improvement. Expansion means what? Oh, well, I already have it, so. Item, city improvement, a mill foundry. I'm just looking at the things that are instant. These are army actions, city improvement. These aren't instant. They're all improvements I have to make.
Yes.
I see.
Things like the language fair are instant, but most other ones are not.
End your turn. Population of Splat has grown to 2. Good for me. Alright, so now I have 2 workers. The Borough Streets. Expansion. Yeah, I had like no food in my last place. Holy shit. Dude, I was just gonna lose that game. Holy fuck, Pat. You're so bad at telling me stuff. Oh god. Alright. Expansion. Construction can now be selected through the list of available constructions. Expansions must be placed directly on the map and can be built several times. For most major factions, 2 additional city workers makes 1 borough available for construction. The borough streets enables you to extend your city. Okay. Click on that, and then click on a place to put it. Okay. It's gonna be queued. Keep in mind that spreading your cities too widely or settling new cities can cause your city approval rating to decrease. Oh, there's an approval rating. Okay. Hover over the approval bar to get the effects. Alright. Yeah, it is $72 for all this shit. Nightblade is the one who bought it for me. I didn't pay for it. He's a nice guy. And Pat's dumb because he doesn't explain anything.
Fuck off.
Don't forget you
have
it's
on sale right now for 50% off, KG Coomer.
And don't forget you have a world to explore. Scouting is the best way to discover shit. To create new units and explore the area, you must have unit designs. Oh, dude, I have a Marine. Holy shit.
Yeah, those guys, you're paying as the Terran.
Yes, Terrans. This is the science Terrans, though. Your Marine has a design. Okay. Add two copies. Two units are queued, but several turns are required to build them. Dust, the most precious resource on Argria, has been introduced yet, but it's stored at the Empire level and can be exploited by our cities. Okay. I have 2k? Wow. Each turn city improvements already built cost a small amount of dust for their upkeep. I like how dust is a fucking resource. It's like fucking bottle caps from Fallout. Just like some stupid thing. The total upkeep of improvements is summed up here. Okay, so... click the browse button. Actually, these are just the two improvements I have. Buy a button. Okay, so you can buy out two of the unit designs I have. And your turn when ready. Okay. Once a unit is constructed, it's placed in the city garrison. Unlike other constructions, each unit created consumes a bit of dust for its upkeep. Okay. Barrier units in the garrison are your city militia. They cannot leave the garrison unless the city is under attack. What is the grayed out stuff? It's the militia. Oh, I see.
Yeah, they can't leave at all.
Motherfuckers. There is the last bastion. Oops, and I just skipped one. Okay, I double-clicked by accident, but whatever. You can create new armies from the garrison. Select two units. Oh, shit. No. I want to control-click. A new army. You have a new army, you can send to explore surrounding ruins. However, you need to limit the amount of armies you have, as they also have an upkeep cost. Okay. You have many ruins to search, any one of them can provide you with rewards. Okay, so Shining. And it's gray again, by the way, but that might be because of the tutorial.
Yeah, that's what this is what it looked like before, where everything looked gray, and I think you might have fucking bugged it somehow.
Oh no, now it's fine. Yeah, it was probably bugged. When exploring with your army, white dots indicate the army's path for this turn. Yellow ones for following turns. You can maintain right click while mousing over the map to simulate your path. The army will move once you release the mouse button. Okay, where are some ruins? No ruins. Are these ruins? No, these are Sisters of Mercy. Fuck them. Are these ruins? No, the dye deposit. Dude, all these. These are just fucking Space Marines. In your turn when you have no movement points left. Okay. Keep exploring until you find the shot. Oh, it's just literally told me. It's like, we're fucking sick of you looking around for it. When standing next to a ruin, select your army. Okay. The game just got kind of tired of me, like, fucking around. It's like, here's where
go
you have to
here,
go.
Go here, asshole!
Splat has grown to 3. Okay, I'm gonna search. I found nothing of interest. They give you unexpected rewards or nothing. You'll have to play. You play will discover different ways to increase your chance of getting a reward. When you search for ruins may give you quests, which can provide more rewards. To explore more rapidly, you may want to split your army up by Okay, so I want to split my army. You already told me how to do this, though.
Oh, yeah.
They cost movement points. It's time for you to make contact with a native minor faction living in your region. Minor factions are hostile. There's only one minor faction per region, living in one to three villages. Villages contain units for defense, but they may spawn roaming units. Okay. Use a parley action in one of the villages. It'll give you a pacification quest. By completing it, all the villages in the region will be instantly pacified and will no longer create hostile armies. Okay, so when standing next to a village with my army selected, right click. Yeah, we know about this. Alright. And we want to parley. The tribe has identified their enemy's lair in the temple ruins to find the monster. So what was the point of not making a city on the borders? Why did you say not to do that?
Because the city cannot expand across borders, and anything on the border, across the border, you don't actually get bonuses from.
Oh, I see. Okay. That's your reasoning. Alright, so it says... I've requested a quest. It has been added to the quest screen. Okay. I have to find a monster. I have to search a monster thing. Oh, here. Okay. Wants me to look at quests. Yeah, I understand that. Oh, I can pin it? Holy shit.
Yep.
Quest marker indicates that the specific runes you have, you go to search for this quest, the location will be even more visible. The location will be even visible through the fog of warp. Note for the other quests, the markers may only be visible within vision range of your army. Alright. Well, let's go over there.
Jason still can't connect to the mobile. God damn it.
Tell him not to have the password in the fucking mobile.
Look, he sent me this.
Okay, let me go look at what the fuck that is.
It had. You might not want to put it on stream.
Okay, I'm not.
That's what he's entering. He said, I got it right, I'm not that retarded.
Label Pat.
Yeah.
Alright, one sec. Oh, it's lewd, Pat, lewd.
Yeah, I know, right?
Alright, let me look. And then it says... Incorrect password?
There's wrong server password for unregistered user account. Please try again.
Fucking fuck. God damn it.
What?
Nothing, I'm just swearing.
Oh, okay.
He didn't register here at any point. What a crazy, crazy bastard. Alright, let me double check the credentials. Give me a sec. That's right.
See, what got me is it's for unregistered users.
You know what? Tell him to maybe do the certificate wizard again. He doesn't have an account here, though. But tell him to do the certificate and make a new certificate, maybe. He doesn't have an account here, so there's no reason he shouldn't be able to log in. He's fucking... That's driving me crazy now. Like, why is he the only one having problems? What? Maybe...
He can join all of our other ones fine.
What version of Mumble does he have? Just check that while I continue doing this tutorial. Whoops, okay. I just got a pop-up. I just construction complete. He really needs to stop doing that.
What?
Like whenever I right-click, it just dismisses it right away. The tribe has identified the enemy's lair. Okay,
so I got it. He has the new version, 1.2.9.
1.29?
Yes.
Then tell him to make a new certificate. By going into Certificate Wizard, and someone's yelling. I need to fight this motherfucker. Marines versus a fucking ogre. Holy shit. This could be really good. Alright. I'm about to launch battle. Here's your encounter panel. Note that battle's placed directly on the terrain of the adventure map. Okay. Depending upon the balance of power and terrain of the battle game, you may prefer to play auto where units and attacks are handled by the computer. Alright. So it's manual normally. Sure, let's do it. So what's offensive? Respective orders cannot be fulfilled. Units will take an offensive stance by default. Oh, I see. Okay, let's fight this motherfucker. Oh, the ogre's running away. Sucker. Welcome to the deployment area. The color of your empire, the opponent's army does the same thing on its tiles. Delimited by the white border. Okay. All units start by taking their default positions and are likely to change when the battle begins. Alright, during a battle you may note that you can click in and out of the battleground if you want to wait, this takes several turns to fight?
Yes. Well, no, this has its own turns inside of the first turn that you started it on.
Holy shit. So like I'll just be like, okay, here's the battle I'm fighting. Let's go back to the city. Oh, let's do something here.
You go back to the city, but
I like how the music changes.
The actual turn cannot end until you finish the battle.
Oh, that's why.
The six turns the battle have are within the one turn for the game.
Oh, that's fucking weird, though. Select one of your units on your side of the battleground. Okay, this guy. So what does this guy do? Point blank power. Alright, so he's unsellable. That's a really nice power that he has. Tech lover. Yes. Techno lover. Plus 50% to the bonus provided by equipment made by the same resources. Holy resource, okay. Tech range of 3 tiles. Alright, so... there's strategy. Oh, that's what he's doing right now. So, what kind of unit is he? He's just arranged. Well, obviously, he's a fucking Marine. Determine where he can move and attack on the battleground, okay. Life is determined by the amount of damage the unit can sustain in attack. My odds to inflict damage. Receive damage, okay. Who developed this game, by the way?
I don't know.
Deal for Blizzard Entertainment. Okay, Blizzard made this game because it's Space Marines. Attributes.
It was
when attacking
Amplitude
next to
Studios.
Okay, never heard of them. When attacking next to friendly units, morale is increased, increasing their attack and defense attributes. They also increase their attack when attacking from higher position, terrain. Force tiles increase the unit, defense, and unit... Okay.
He made a new certificate and he's getting the same error.
Oh my fucking god. I don't know what he did.
Right?
I really don't know how he fucked it up. Like, let me look at it one more time. Edit server. Maybe you should just delete it and make another one? I don't know. Maybe put in some random ass username? That's the only two things I can think of. What happens when he actually What happens if he actually goes to that address? What did you guys already try?
We tried a shit ton of usernames.
Okay, so username is the problem.
He got the same error every time.
One sec, maybe let me SSH in my server. Except I really can't because I'm under Windows, thanks, by the way.
No problem.
Because maybe there's like a log saying why it failed. Sorry guys, I'm doing some server stuff. Whoops. No, did I just cancel a fucking... Okay, whatever.
Okay, he says if he goes to the actual URL for the Mumble, it takes him to the forums.
Okay, that's what it should do. Let's log. Apparently Mumble server requires root access because it's running as some fucking weird user. I gotta help this guy get in because he's gonna play with us.
And he's a good guy. You know, you gotta add that part in too.
Alright, let me see. Okay, so he's tried it recently. Oh, wait, here we go. Okay. I'm seeing invalid server password. That's why it's rejecting him.
Okay, I linked it to you, by the way.
I know you did.
And it's the right password, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like, that's his... Yeah, then why is it happening?
Yeah, it's literally saying he's failing because of the password.
I showed you what he entered in.
I'm just telling you what the logs say. I'm not trying to justify this in any way. CDX... Okay. Let me check the password on the fucking thing. Like, everybody here uses it.
Yeah, but haven't most of the people here...
Okay, one sec. Let me check out how mine does it. See, I don't even have a password. I don't even have a password field. Why does he have one? Like, it asks me when I connect.
Because he's still never connected to the server. Once you connect to the server, it gives you the option to not have to enter the password again and save it by
creating a certificate. No, even if I add a new server. Even if I add a new server, doesn't it have the password field? Tell him to leave the password empty, maybe. You said what? What version of Mumble? 1.28?
Yes.
How?
I don't know.
This guy is fucking weird. Tell him to leave it empty.
I told him to leave the password empty, says Mike. Let's see.
I have no idea. So he added this to his favorites, right?
Hold on, he's writing something. And he's usually very quick about writing, and he hasn't entered in anything yet. So this is going to be good. I think he's getting mad.
I'm trying to help this guy out, okay?
I like Jason. He's alright.
Capacity is... Or special abilities used by units when attacking or being attacked. The range capacity, for example, gives maximum distance where a unit can attack.
Okay. He entered in no password and he got this.
Alright. Sec. Oh, you gave it to me on Steam. Where is Steam? There it is. I have so many windows open. Wrong certificate or password for a registered user. It thinks he's registered. Okay, dude, he's not registered. There's no way. I'm looking at this. He's not registered. His name isn't here. Okay, I'm looking at the L's and there's nothing there. Dude, there's so many weird people registered on my server here. Thinker, Wing Ascendant, Wikidoo, who's that? Who's Wikidoo? God, no, I'm just joking.
Who the fuck knows?
I'm just kidding. Who's Pat? Fuck. Sounds like a loser's name. Okay,
there's probably a lot of Pats. There's probably Pat, Paticus, VG Pat.
I'm just giving you information I know. He, as far as I know, like, it's just saying he wrong password for user, and it's saying... he's not registered, so...
No way, he did it! We got him in! He's
Holy
here!
Holy shit, okay.
Holy shit, Snacks.
Okay, let me get ring in. One sec. I'm streaming right now, so don't say anything related to the server right now. Like, any intricate details. What'd you do to fix it? Okay. Now he needs to fix his microphone.
He says, fuck if I know Raffle. You can talk, asshole.
I'm doing a tutorial for this game. And the game is not freezing.
He just said not to say the password, not to say, not no talking. God damn it.
Okay. I can't hear him, by the way.
He says he's just following instructions because you said no talking.
Oh, no, I didn't tell him not to talk. I just said don't say anything about the password.
What?
Exactly.
Yeah. I'm just doing a tutorial for this game. So what was the problem?
I have no idea. I'm entirely blameless on Pat.
Fuck you.
If you says it was the wrong password, then you gave me the wrong password.
How can I get it wrong when I'm literally linking from the forums? Mike, back me up on this.
I don't know, dude. I copy-paste everything you ever send to me.
I mean, I looked at the screenshot, and it's, like, looks fine, but whatever.
I don't even know.
Okay. Anyways, let me finish up this tutorial, and then we'll start another game, I guess. Alright. Capabilities are special abilities automatically used by units when attacking or be attacked. The range capacity gives the maximum distance from a unit attacking. Mouse over capacity is good. Okay. Interesting. Alright, deployment phase enables you to change the position of units at will. Select a unit and right click on the tile, set a new position, then press ready when you're happy with their new deployment. Okay, so maybe I'll just put them like over here. Because I think they need to be three tiles away. One, two, three. So I'll put them like right here. Unless that the hills are going to block them.
I think certain terrain deadlock, but I don't think those do. I could be wrong.
You probably are.
You're always wrong.
God damn it.
Okay. Press ready once you're done. Where's ready? Where's the ready button? Oh, there. Ready.
Are you fucking serious here?
Shut up. You've entered the first... Okay, so that's... so they can attack over the hills. Each unit will move and attack in each round. The initiative bar shows the order in which... Okay, so that's what you're saying to me. The initiative bar.
Yes.
Select one of your units. For each unit, you can choose between three strategies. Aggressive and cautious will set more or less aggressive. Targeting while hold position will order your unit to stay where it is and only attack when it's within range. In addition, you can manually select a destination or target. Your unit will try and focus during resolution phase if you can even... You can set a position, right-click, and select a target. Control right-click in order to have more control. Select a unit and then right-click on a tile or enemy unit that you want to target. Okay, I want to target him. Oh, wait. Okay, so... Oh, I see. So it's whenever it can't do something, it'll either be defensive or it'll be offensive.
Yes.
Okay. I see.
Basically, you choose the AI for each turn.
How do they last?
But you can also give them direct order.
How do they last six rounds maximum? So what happens at the end? We just both lose.
It just stops.
And then you can just reinitiate it, I guess.
Yep.
I would imagine it's probably just designed like that because the battles would take an ungodly amount of time if you were in multiplayer.
I see.
And if somebody is just trying to run away, like the six turn thing is there to prevent that from just, you know, being an actual legitimate strategy.
I just wrecked this guy. You get shrecked.
Jason, if it makes you feel any better, the first match me and Mike played only lasted about two turns because Mike fucked up.
Two turns.
Yeah.
It's lasted several turns.
I at least made it to six.
Yeah.
I made it past six, motherfucker. It just had no production.
Yeah, on the second match.
What?
Yeah, on the second match. Remember the first one we had to cancel out of.
Whatever. Draw situation can also occur when there are survivors on both sides. In that case, another battle can be launched. The armor still has action points. Okay. Okay, so I killed the battle guy.
Then you got experience, too. Oh yeah, your units level up. Did I forget to mention that?
Yeah, you did. They have a skill tree. No, the heroes have a skill tree. This guy does not.
Yes. But those guys can equip armor and shit.
You can also see the effect
of new versions of them, though.
Three village workers have joined my city because of the pacification. If you attack each, pacification is also possible village by village if you attack each of them. However, in that case, you would need to rebuild each village in order to obtain additional workers. So why were people telling me it was a waste of time to fucking pacify the dwarves?
I don't know. People are weird.
Okay. The Empire Screen is a global dashboard that lets you review Empire status and take critical Empire-wide decisions. Okay, because I think it's in my territory, I think that's why.
Yes.
The other one was not. In the main banner, select the Empire Screen button. Where is that? Oh, that thing. Oh, luxury resources.
Oh boy.
Okay, once used, the luxury resources stay active for a certain amount of turns. This is die. The more regions you have, the more expensive luxury boosters will be. Okay. Oh, I see. It's interesting. Each major faction has its own affinity and traits.
Yeah, those are the ones that, like, where the one person can only build one town. Some can't declare war. Just little shit like that that actually makes a big difference.
Some can't declare war, that's awesome.
Yeah, the traitors can, which is a real piss-off if you want to actually be an asshole.
you're prevented from being an asshole. You'll find all the Empire bonuses currently applied on your Empire. Oh, I see. Every 20 turns, all the Empires can set at the same time an Empire plan. By spending influence, you can... Oh. You can unlock powerful bonuses. Okay. So it's limited by every 20 turns.
Yes.
Task screen, you'll be able to review your objectives in that of other empires. And assimilated minor factions. I see. So if you assimilate them, at least one of the villagers must be pacified within your empire. Remember, recently you recently pacified. Okay, so
pacified.
All right.
You pacified, Mike.
Sister Mercy faction now gives you plus 15 health regeneration in your regions. Haha, I'm Call of Duty. Their unit design is now available to be built in your city. Okay. Now you don't have enough die luxury resist activated specs. Alright, die luxury deposit was discovered in your region. It's that thing right there. Extractors allow you to collect resources. These expansion can be built directly on it. Okay. Die extractor. Well done. Note that strategic resources can also be collected by building extractors if your regions contain corresponding deposits. Remember that, like most constructions, extractors normally require specific technologies that need to be researched. Okay, there's a lot. Oh, I see. So it's basically like uranium. New unit designs. You can improve your units by creating new unit designs using the strategic resources that you've collected. Oh, I see. Okay. This is now where we get to basically do the Sims. Okay. Addition to military screen is where you edit design. So you click on it and press new. Select my unit model. Ooh, okay, let's make this the sword person titties thing. And yes, we really do get to fucking make all this shit. Okay, you can edit designs, bubble on the list of possible constructions. My fucking god. Torso armor. Holy fuck, man. You can... See tier 1 army. Advanced user technology. Sorry, wait. Some items require strategic resources to be spent when the unit is constructed. Items made of strategic resources, as well as advanced weapon and armor tiers, will unlock So you basically get to customize your own fucking army.
Yes.
Railguns.
Fucking Jason's power went out.
Really?
Yes.
That's fucking
That's good. Amazing.
What were the chances? Apparently rings are something I can put onto people.
And necklaces.
I can't, this person can't have a ring.
Yes, they can. It goes down to the bottom.
Oh. It's a special thing. Okay. Okay, so I can't really, like, hover over it to... Oh, here, this is where I hover over it. Interesting. That's a shield. Okay, I already have a shield.
He doesn't have boots, Mike. You can also double-click on stuff, too, and it'll just move it over there without you having to drag it.
I see. It's like a virtual waifu. Alright. As you see, tier 1 titanium items of armory require strategic resources to be spent. Items of strategic resources as well as advanced weapon and armor tiers unlock as you advance through these things. Okay.
Vortai, I love you.
I already fucking did this. Once you're happy with the design, enter a name and click validate. I fucking did that. Why is this thing still here? Stop. Validate. Okay, it's not letting me fucking do anything else. I think I broke it.
Or you did the wrong unit.
Alright, it says... But I did both the units. Oh wait, maybe I'm supposed to put this on? Oh, I think that's what I was supposed to do. I was supposed to put something with fucking shit on it. No, it's not. It's not going away. Oh, you can end your turn when you're ready. Maybe I should read it.
God fucking damn it.
How do I delete these? I'm gonna delete some of these. Alright.
I can't read Archangel. I just kind of like, you know.
Alright, it's time to learn about read.
Play it by ear.
Okay, I can learn about the heroes. Heroes can be injured but not killed on the battleground. Okay. To be of use, a hero has to be assigned to an army as a general or to a city as a governor. Depending upon the profile and the hero skills, it will give different bonuses to the city. Okay, click to inspect or double click on your hero on the academy screen. And it's some person with a bow. They can instantly equip new items as long as they're in the academy or located in within your territory. You can immediately spend resources to change their equipment. Okay. Dude, this person has a crossbow. It's fucking amazing.
It's too bad you're never gonna get Valiant Lightning again.
The fuck are you even talking about?
Remember how you got that one quest for the dwarves and they were gonna give you that railgun crossbow?
Oh yeah. He says I'll never get it again. Improve damage. Okay. Click on the skill tree to learn about hero experience. Okay. Each level, they earn one additional skill point, but it can be used through constructions or through... So is Jason not coming, by the way?
He's back, just trying to figure out why his computer crashed while you do the tutorial.
Okay. Normal games advanced.
Or his power will not be revealed
through the unlock of new technologies or by dealing with other empires. Marketplace is one of these and gives you, among other things, the possibility to recruit new heroes for your empire. Neat. You can assign your first hero to an army or your city. Once assigned, a defined number of turns must be passed before your hero can be reassigned. Yeah, we already know about that. Apparently I'm fine. I'm good to go. Apparently, I lost. What the fuck? Oh, that's because here.
You lost?
No, shut up. No. Okay, apparently I got an achievement for completing the fucking tutorial.
Well, so you're done?
Congratulations. Yeah, it looks like I'm done. Okay, I understand a lot more now. So, is Jason coming?
Yeah.
Alright. Well, I'm starting a game again, so I'm gonna get something. I'll be back in just a minute.
You learn nothing from that, Keiji Kumar. That was actually a fairly decent-ish tutorial. Now we get to watch Mike just unlearn everything. No, you weren't here, Keiji. Well, then that's your own fucking fault, brah. Brah! I think I want to play as the cultist, just for shits and giggles. Mike will play as who he wants to play as. I learned a long time ago how to try to force him to do things. He'll be fine playing as whoever. I'm sure of that much.
What the fuck? Where is he?
Where am I?
He says,
one second.
Okay.
Also, I restarted the game because I wanted to make it higher quality. Did you invite him to the game?
Join on your own.
Well, I joined, but can you invite him?
Fuck, where is he? What's his name again on Steam?
Lazy Canuck.
Is he in the game?
No. I think he's getting a drink or something. I never know with this kid.
This kid, huh?
Yeah, this kid.
Apparently may not have him in my... I don't know. No, I don't have him in there. Okay.
Good.
Alright, let me look at the factions again. Maybe I won't be the mages.
They are actually... actual quest is relatively difficult.
They should be Space Marines.
Space Marine!
Which Space Marines? Because there's two Space Marines.
Well, let's see more Space Marines than normal. But they're too religious. I don't like religion. Screw that.
Fair enough. Nightblade has just been on a tirade saying, make Mike play the Broken Lords. Broken Lords. Broken Lords. Broken Lords.
They do expansion, though.
They're also kind of weird to play as.
Why? Cannot use HP regen. Can use dust to heal units. Yeah. Not see, gather, or use food. What the fuck?
Yes.
Interesting.
Okay, he's here in Mumble now. He just...
Oh.
Hey, I don't think he can move down here on his own yet.
No, he can't. He'd have to register.
Bye.
Jason!
Oh, that was weird.
Yeah, well, I can imagine when that happens, that's weird.
It's the first time it's done that.
So well, at least you didn't explode.
They're basically Jewish. That's funny.
What?
Somebody in the stream chat's being is being weird.
So what did the Zerg even do? Apparently they do so much that there's a scroll bar on it. That's a
yes,
good sign.
They are fucking awesome.
Plus one cadaver for any unit killed in battle. So basically I want to fight everything.
Yes. When you get so many cadavers, you get a stockpile of food and you can eat all the bodies.
Wow. Okay, let's not do that. Okay, there's the Yoshis. Let's see.
Pat.
What?
Give me your color.
I'll be pink then.
Damn right you'll be pink. Yeah, Pat, I don't even know what the hell I would check to even see what did cause that.
Who even knows? Mike, do you not like the dragon people?
I don't know what they do, though.
They are dragons.
Oh, you automatically know the location of every other race's capital? What the fuck?
Yes.
That's so OP.
But they don't know where you are.
But what is the Wander victory type? What the fuck does that even mean?
I think with them, that means they complete their main quest line, which involves them building really big and elaborate bullshit.
So they're like production.
More or less, yeah.
To grow into rocks and trees, creating towns. Oh, fucking hell. I don't know, I'm thinking of the Broken Lords, actually, to be honest.
No, that's fine. It's an interesting group, but you'll basically not even have to worry about food.
Yeah, no food, okay. Okay, let's do, fuck that. No food.
Oh boy, the Green Broken Lords. I've never actually played as the Broken Lords, to be honest.
Okay, Pat, you were authenticating at some point?
Yeah, well, you gotta synchronize to the server, brah. You can get desynced in this game, it's hilarious.
Yeah, we found that out yesterday.
That was fucking great.
That was quite the conga line of errors that we ended up getting because of that.
Oh god, yes. What do you mean, Dr. Poop Ticker or Pat pirated this game? I'm playing it on Steam. You tard.
Pirated version of Steam.
Oh, that's actually a thing, too. But I don't use that anymore.
But why would... you know what? I don't even care.
Because you can just download all the games from Steam, from the pirated version of Steam.
Yeah.
But guess what it's called?
Stom?
No, Steam with a C.
That... okay.
So, Steam?
Yeah, it's like... I don't even know how you'd pronounce it. Drank and loved as mortal beings. But our world changed and we faced a stark choice. Oh. Alter our
bodies or perish. I can see all of you. Survival is not the same as life.
Now we are prisoners of the armor that binds us and the dust that sustains us. We must drain dust. Drain.
Better stop that.
Or die.
I'm creeping on all of you.
Our honor now, lords of the Amber Plains. And what matters more? To reclaim
fucking
our
Jason's
honor,
playing as the goddamn. I don't even remember.
The dragon
people.
The dragon.
I'm playing as Israel.
God damn it.
Ah, hey, it's Lazy Canuck. Start negotiation. Alright.
No, it does it automatically.
You wanna declare war on Pat right now?
No, we'll wait a couple turns before we go kill Pat.
Okay. You guys go fuck off.
we don't wanna seem completely ruthless.
Oh, okay, yeah. What? Just wait a little bit, and then we'll be good, okay?
Yeah. Sorry. Pretty much.
Let's see.
Oh boy, let's do this.
I think you're right there right now, but let's have a look around first. I was watching the cutscene, by the way, while you two people were talking.
Yeah, we figured.
Libby, the lizard people is one of the human players. You silly Billy.
Lizard people.
Lizard people.
Time to rob a bank, Mike? Alright. So there's the Doitus.
Doitus. Those guys are assholes, by the way. They have ranged attack and they hurt like a motherfucker.
They're all asshole.
That may be true.
I mean, we found that out the hard way.
Yeah, well, that's why we kill everyone now.
Actually, let me see how much resources I have here. Okay.
Triple strike. Lol, Mike chose the shit production area again.
Look, there's already a guy on production, it's okay. And I'm gonna research production right away.
Fair enough. That's usually the good strategy to go with. How can that fail?
So why would I care? Because it's just like, that place was amazing. Open pit mine? Holy fuck. Why do I hear myself? I sound like a chipmunk.
Hello?
Oh, it's only gonna take 9 turns this time. Only.
Yeah, instead of the 3. I don't have the stream open, I'm just watching the chat.
So how do I make people then?
I actually don't know.
I have to buy every person, every population.
Wow. That's hilarious.
That's crazy.
Is that what that race does?
Yeah.
Well, they don't get food.
Oh, yeah, because that would make sense.
Okay, escort of Broken Lords. Hero with at least 3 infantry units to inspect unspoiled ruins. So infantry units are just like my little soldiers, right?
I would suppose so.
I have a mission to do that. This is templed ruins, not unspoiled. Or maybe that's exactly what it is. Whatever. Oh man, I got dust. And so now the next one costs even more.
How high does it go?
It doubles every time I buy a worker, it seems.
Oh, well, that seems like it could get out of control very quickly.
Well, I think that's to balance it with regards to food, you know?
Yeah, I guess.
Oh god, that's a boss battle, Mike? I fucking love boss battles.
I'm pretty sure they start with Empire Man, too. So you can build, like, an early gold thing.
Yes, I can.
Yeah, and then fucking Jason can just go over there and be the Peacekeeper.
What?
You'd be the Peacekeeper with your wyverns.
Oh, yeah, lots of wyverns.
Winter Wyvern?
He's the best.
Fuck okay. Winter.
How long is this thing taking now? 4 turns.
He doesn't know about that yet, Jason.
Oh, he will.
What do I not know about?
You'll see.
You'll see.
Okay.
That's all we can say.
Okay.
That's all we can say.
Shut up, Pat.
Fuck off. Thought it was funny.
If you thought it was funny, then it's not actually funny.
Move my units.
Damn.
How can I,
brutal.
I can't undo my turn. Damn it. I can't.
Oh. Could you undo your turn in Sith 5?
I could make more actions. But whatever. Oh, this unspoiled runes. That's the kind of thing I want. Oh, look. Oh, snake people. Fuck yeah.
And Mike and his skillies.
he found the hydras.
Yeah.
They want you to assimilate them, Mike.
I can see the world.
And you?
I can see the entire world. Because for some reason, dragon people just automatically see the whole fucking planet.
Maybe you can fly, right?
Not that high.
So, the thing is when I seduce a village, though, it has to be my territory, doesn't it?
No.
It doesn't have to be, but to assimilate them, they have to be in your territory.
Okay.
Yeah. But you can pacify them without them being in your territory.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
Most of their missions are complete bullshit anyway, and just makes you want to kill them. I'm pretty sure I ran into one group of them that wanted me to kill the other to pacify them, and then that group that they wanted me to kill the other ones to pacify them. It was like, what?
I keep finding these fucking made-up resources and shit like that.
You found bananas.
Everybody loves bananas.
Except you.
Yeah, it's because, you know, food allergies suck ass.
Maybe you're just weak. You ever think about that?
Yes.
Pretty good.
Oh, you know, it just occurred to me, I don't have my hero doing anything.
Why not?
I don't know. I don't know why I did that. Quiet.
Are you fighting people, Pat?
Yeah, I'm fighting people.
Are they frog people?
Such a little warmonger.
I can't help it. I have to kill. Killing is all I know.
For me to live, I have to kill.
Is that actually what one of the races is?
Yes, the necrophage, basically, yeah.
Turn remaining one battle. Okay, someone's fighting.
Yeah, that's fighting.
Me. Sorry. Damn, man, I have like 700 ping to you, Mike.
Because I'm streaming.
Yeah,
I got 300.
And you two live like right next to each other, so I should be. Oh wait, no, not anymore. You used to.
Whatever.
Not everybody in Canada lives near each other, Pat.
Well, could have fooled me. Okay, sorry about that. The battle's done. My hero died.
Good job.
Alright.
I gotta fight again.
Oh man, I got some dyes. Fuck yeah. Pat, you could say it's to die for.
Fuck you, that's my line.
Oh my god.
He's like a more Canadian version of me.
So there doesn't need to be any more versions of you.
No, right?
Gift 10 wine to the new public market of Joitus.
Fuck of you. Coitus?
No, Joitus. I mean, I see some wine right there, but... I think this is the wine. No, that's not the wine, is it? No?
No, that's Dorgeji.
Are you watching his stream? Oh, no, wait, you have vision. Or maybe your origin stream, I don't know.
He gets cheating by default.
Yeah, forget about that.
Yeah, I get to cheat by default, basically.
The built-in map hacks. I'm done researching, so... In areas where resources or effects may be hidden... This is 10%. How long does it take? 4 turns. How about no?
How about yes?
But no.
Oh. Okay.
No sounds like a better idea.
Well, Libby, I gave him 5 gold. I don't think it's going to help him very much.
I'm not screen cheating. I'm not the one fucking watching this shit. Fucking yell at Jason, not me.
I'm not screen cheating, I'm watching the chat.
Is that even a thing in this game, screen cheating?
I don't know. It doesn't seem like it should be, but...
I mean, I don't think either of us know anything about this game. Enough to fucking make any use of that kind of shit.
Meh. It's not like we're going to be trying to kill each other anyway, that'd be a real dick move.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, we're not going to kill Pat at all.
Right.
Oh,
man. Mike, you shouldn't have built your city right on the border like that.
Yeah, weren't we, didn't we warn you about that?
It wasn't right on the border.
And it's pretty close, though. You're not going to be able to get much expansion.
No, I could expand up.
Yeah, up, but... Well, I guess there's a rune there. Wait, you didn't even search that rune that's literally right next to your city.
No, that appeared, I think. I don't think that was there when I started.
I'm pretty sure runes are always there.
Okay, fine, I'll just explore it now, then.
You might be able to use your hero to do that if it's still in the capital.
Well, no, it's assigned to the capital.
Oh, well, then, yeah, you just... Whatever, whenever you build a unit, you can just have them quickly search that. Unless, I don't know, Pat, do runes just magically appear, or does the game just find a rune to use for a quest marker?
I think it just finds one to use for a quest marker.
Yeah, I think they're always there.
Oh, okay. Sure. Fair enough.
I honestly don't remember, but...
I'm waiting on you right now.
Oh, hey? Shit.
Yeah.
I thought I hit the button already. I guess I didn't. Could have said something. Wasn't doing anything.
I didn't expect you to know.
That's why you said something.
Yeah, like a minute and a half later. I blame Pat.
That's usually a good strategy.
Goddamn Pat. Fuck.
Yeah, come on, Pat.
Look, you guys.
You had to know this was coming.
So. Oh, yeah. I get two Canadians together, it's just like instantly hate Pat. Or
if we can't kill you in game, we'll kill you on Mumble.
No, that's true.
Alright.
Wait, what?
What?
Holy shit.
What'd you do?
This fucking side quest has four things to it.
Oh, Jesus.
The hell game.
Okay, Mike, the face that your hero makes is great. Can I just say that?
He doesn't have a face. But yes, it's like a horror.
It's like a
rah! Oh yeah. No,
found the eyeless ones. That's fun.
Produce 40 science in one of your cities for 10 turns. Okay. And how much science do I produce right now?
Okay, Nightblade, you can go suck it. I've only played this game for a day, too.
Basically that much. Someone criticizing you?
Apparently runes do appear, and I wasn't aware of that. Excuse me for only having played two games and not knowing.
Well, it's okay, it's okay. There's no need to get... just,
I want to see your games. I want to see him fight.
I just met the bear centaur people.
You mean the minotaurs?
The Garron.
Yeah, whatever. Whatever they are.
They're minotaurs, Mike. Bear centaur people, really? Even says they're minotaurs.
Pat, they're bear centaur people. Return to this village when you're ready to get in the 100 dust. How about fuck no? They can go fuck right off. It's literally my people's lifeblood.
So judgmental.
It's people's lifeblood.
Oh, don't even think that's the end of it. You'll give them 100 dust, and then they'll get you, make you do something else after.
I did have one of those.
Yeah, it's like, alright, fuck you, I'm just gonna murder all of you people.
Or you could just do what I do and kill everyone around you.
Yeah, or that.
How'd that work out for you, by the way, Pat?
It's actually working out pretty well.
Oh, okay.
Got my first level on my hero already.
Allegedly, I'm missing a lot of stuff.
No, they're just trolling you.
That sounds about right.
Can I buy a wyvern? Probably not.
A lot of science here.
Let's just speed that up.
These motherfuckers want fucking 10 emeralds and 10 blood crystals. I don't even know if I could get blood crystals yet.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's like third era, isn't it?
That's retarded.
Because, you know, why not?
So produce 40 science in one of my cities for 10 turns, and it's just not going up.
Yeah, because you're not producing 40 science.
Yeah, you have to produce that much in one turn.
It says for 10 turns.
Yeah.
Yes. You have to do 40 science in one turn for 10 turns.
Like, open up your city, Mike.
Oh, fucking hell. That's stupid.
Like you said, if you open up your city and if you look at all the resources, at the bottom on totals, yeah, it has to equal 40. And it has to be at that for 10 turns. I don't think you can even come close to that this early in the game.
It's like fucking 17.
Yeah. Like I said, I don't think you can even get anywhere near 40 this early in the game.
Early than 10 now. Can Mike read? No. No, I can't.
Neither can I, don't worry.
Are you fighting again? Jesus Christ.
Yes, I'm fighting every turn. You'd probably auto it, but, you know, whatever.
Probably.
There's so much gold. I just have gold vision all over the map. It's glorious, Pat. Imagine being a race where all you see everywhere is money. Exactly.
I feel like that's racist, but...
Probably a little bit.
What race is I referring to?
The Broken Lords, obviously.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know what you're thinking about.
We all always thinking about.
Nah, that's all on you. Anyway,
I'm trying to kill these guys as quickly as I can. Just watched my preacher kick a guy in the shin.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
I have really no reason to expand here at all. I get some more monies here, I guess. And I also should make the library. Why can't I make a library, though?
You haven't researched it yet.
Thought I did. Oh no, I'm in the middle of researching it.
It's still going, you got two turns left.
My bad.
Oh boy. Fucking Mike can't into science.
Well, you can't into not fucking battling every fucking turn.
Fine, I'll just auto them from now on, Jesus. I just like to kill people. What's so wrong with that?
Typical merit.
I'm there. You happy?
I'm pretty sure I didn't spell that right.
Who?
Nothing.
Okay.
Yeah, I've reduced the... I have to mix the E and the A the other way around.
No, actually, you did get it right. Israel is the proper way.
No, I did it real, as in, like, real.
Yeah, it's not supposed to be, like, Israel. It's supposed to be Israel.
Okay, you just ruined the whole joke, okay? Now it's no longer
fuck
fun.
Fuck you.
No, that's fucking... Really? Can't go that much more?
Aw, wrecked.
God damn it.
I found nothing of interest.
Yeah, that has. It's irritating.
Like the game hates me.
The game hates everybody.
That's very true.
Like, there's not even a debate on that. This game just hates everybody.
Kidnap brothers are in a nearby region called Baldwin. Locate the right village and then with a marker and destroy it. Holy shit.
Free all people.
And now I met the fat people. Literally centaurs. Literally.
Well, don't you like big fat centaur titties?
Apparently. These are not the centaur titties I had in mind.
I'm gonna Google centaur titties real quick.
Okay. No.
I
immediately regret your decision.
Yes.
Now I need to look this up.
Don't do it on stream.
I know better.
Oh my god, Pat! Why?
Did you mean centaur tattoos?
Is that right?
You know, I have I see nothing about this because safe search is on. I'm guessing you have safe search off.
I do. I got a lot of My Little Pony stuff, don't worry.
You know, Pat, you don't have post stuff like to make everybody hate you.
You know, I don't actually have safe search on. What the fuck is this even going on about?
I don't know, but if you're done moving, end your turn.
No, we're looking at centaurs. You know, literally, there's nothing wrong, Pat. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not even bullshitting you.
The first thing I see on mine is a fucking My Little Pony character as a centaur with gigantic titties.
Well, ain't that something?
Ain't that fucking something, yes. Ooh. Also, the new XCOM has snake tits.
Yeah, I'll even show on stream. This is all I see. It's nothing here. You're lame, Pat. So look, see?
Is that a butterfly?
You misspelled centaur.
You misspelled centaur, for one thing.
Whoops. Alright, let me go back to the game then.
Yeah, you probably don't want to actually correct that.
Oh, Jesus.
Everything suddenly makes a lot more sense. Mike's an idiot.
Yeah, Pat, I'm gonna just leave my city's name like this. Just because I hate you. Oh god, Pat. Is that the lizard
Are
people?
You not prepared for new XCOM?
Why? Yeah. Why did she post a goddamn Lamia?
I don't know if you're allowed
that's
to do that.
That's going to be in the new XCOM, did you not know that?
Pretty good.
That's pretty good, he says.
You can't ban Pat. He'll find a way back in.
Yeah, I really will.
No, you won't.
There's nothing wrong with that picture. There are no actual teats. Just memories. I actually ended up just stopping exploration completely, because if I keep exploring, I'm going to keep fighting.
Oh, whoops. Fuck, I did it again.
What'd you do?
I ended my turn, yeah.
Yeah, I wish I did that a lot.
I wish it would tell me before I fucking ended it. Like, is there a setting for that?
Well, I don't know if there is, but your best bet is to always just look at that little, refresh button right next to the end turn button, and if it's got a number on it, that means you have units that haven't been moved yet.
You have to fucking do that. Well.
But otherwise, I don't really know. Like, you see on your screen, it'll have a number 2 on it.
Yeah, I know. I'm just not used to that, because Civ would tell different. Me. No, wait. This village has been pacified, but no one yet controls it. I think I've been where Pat is.
Someone's killed it.
No, you're next to Teal. I'm not Teal. I'm very far to the north. Like, I'm actually on the border of the actual map. On the north.
Yeah, somebody else has been killed it.
Whoever Teal is. Which could very well end up being the necrophage.
Oh, isn't that lovely?
Jason, you know who all the people in the game are.
Oh, yeah, that's right. No, Teal's not the necrophage.
Who is it?
It's, the Arcane Mages, I believe.
Oh.
You don't even have any Necrophages in this game, so.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, seriously.
Nightblade, we have fucking Jason over there who's got goddamn dragon vision and can see everybody.
Dragonite. Need to colonize this place in order to make these people my friends. Oh. Wait, no, I don't. Do I have a quest from them? No, I suppose I do, because they're right here. Yeah, I do.
Oh.
It's weird that I can't actually see it again.
They keep telling you to do your quest.
Which one?
The one in the top right corner.
Well, that one's like, that one's apparently going to get me killed.
Maybe.
Oh, look, I discovered the pain people. See, how do you make suffer what enjoys, like, gold?
What?
No! How would...
I don't know,
Pat. Oh my god. How do you make suffer gold? What?
No, because my people are all about, like, having gold, so... Like, how do you make them suffer? It's fucking deep, man.
But I do have headphones.
Apparently, they can hear my mic a second time through you.
Yes. Yes, they can. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I can hear myself.
Woo!
Alright, well, how the hell do I turn that off?
I have no idea.
Shouldn't be doing that.
How loud are your headphones that your mic is picking them up?
Learn how to speak, nerd. No.
No, it's... My headphones are... Like, encased in. There should be no sound coming through at all.
Hmm. Weird.
Like I said, this is a completely brand new computer, so some of my settings could be completely fucked right now. I really don't know.
So apparently winter is coming and it's gonna suck balls.
Don't... Nobody tell Mike about this shit.
Yeah, no, but it says here in a pop-up. But
really?
I'm the gold... Yeah, you hover over the weather.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I guess I should warn you that winter is coming, and when it comes, things are gonna get really shitty.
I don't have speakers, Libby. It's just headphones. Unless you mean something else.
To be honest, Archangel... I doubt that's the case, because it actually... He had the same thing going on his previous computer, and he's got a brand new one now.
Could just be the headphones, I really don't know.
Yeah, he has a shaving mic. You know, I probably shouldn't be in this guy's territory, because he's probably going to annoy him.
No, remember what happened last time you were in somebody's territory?
It killed me.
Yeah.
It sucked.
When winter comes, there's gonna be white stuff everywhere. Okay, I wonder what happens if I type in winter coming in Google.
Please don't.
It's basically just a lot of frozen porn.
Oh shit. That's funny. Because I still need one more inventory to inspect the terrain. For fuck's sake, Pat. the guy wants to battle me. Retreat. Your troop made a successful retreat. Where are they? That's it? I don't get a choice of anything to do, it's just, I don't fight them?
Yeah, but you lose half the health on all your units.
Oh, I see. Let's run away. What a fucking dick.
Basically, here are the rules of Cold War. Anyone can fight anyone else in neutral areas without any repercussions. They can also fight you if they are in your territory. Or vice versa. Without declaring war. But they cannot come into your territory and fight you without declaring war.
Interesting.
That's pretty much all you need to know really about the Cold War.
Escalation. So how do I regen these guys' health then?
They don't have health regen. You have to pay dust for their health regen.
You fucking serious?
Yeah.
God damn it. And where do I do that? Oh, heal 53? Holy shit, fuck that. I'm not healing these guys. You can stay that way. Fuck that. Who's in battle?
Me.
God damn it. In encounter.
This won't take long.
God damn it, Jason. Who the fuck are you killing already?
I'm not killing anybody. I got attacked.
Oh, okay.
Goddamn angry vine snake.
Apparently, Nightblade is mad that I posted that picture.
Oh, is he?
Apparently I got him in trouble.
Did you really?
If I'm reading his words right, yes.
You could have really fucked me over.
He's in school.
He mad.
Why is he in school watching this? Wouldn't you be doing something like learning?
Who wants to learn?
Yeah, who goes to school to learn? Everyone just goes to school to pass the time.
Oh, he's in his dorm. Why would you get in trouble then? It's not like your mom's behind you. I hope she's not.
His mom's the teacher.
The college teacher.
Nightblade! Are you watching them Twitch streams again? Or not Twitch, the fucking Hitbox streams again?
Oh yeah, pass. These random people.
What would your roommate think if you're looking at porn, honestly? Let's be honest.
He's like,
though.
Hey bro, share me some of those snake tits.
Exactly.
Bro, you're in the Yoshi boar? Me too!
Oh my god.
It's not even normal porn though. Who cares? Who cares?
What?
I said who cares if it's not normal? Whoops, and I just clicked to release this.
Well beyond the whole normal thing.
With Mike here, yeah.
Fucking, he's battling me again, and they're gonna die.
Yeah, they're gonna chase you down. It's just what the NPCs like to do. It's incredibly annoying.
But I'm going to lose 50% of my health again. Or is that 50% of my current health?
I think it's just 50% of
your
health.
He's going to die.
I think he'll survive one more round, but I imagine they'll just keep chasing him. Because that's just what
Yeah,
they
he's
do.
Dead.
Well, they don't like it when we go into their region,
oh,
I guess.
Yeah, no, I guess he's just dead.
They're fucking...
Yeah,
what the fuck?
That happens a lot. It is annoying.
That's so dumb. All I want to do is be peaceful. But, like, I had no opportunity to run away from them.
Yeah, that's what happens. I had that happen to me a couple times. It is incredibly annoying.
Ted, what is this fucking... What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck?
Yoshi!
Explain it, Pat.
There is no explanation for that.
Dude, it's disturbing just for the fact that someone made that.
Oh, dude, their whole fucking page is shit like that.
Man, it's the internet. Everything exists.
What the fuck, man? Yay, dust.
Mama Luigi. Somebody needs to get rid of Pat's mods privilege. Nah. My mod privileges are the best.
So cities get too big, your approval rating drops, I'm guessing?
More or less.
Yeah, they don't like expansion, and there's a bunch of little things that they don't like.
Let's see. I think it's hilarious though that everything costs money for me. Alright. So there's a resource booster.
Oh yeah, if you have 10 of something, you can click on the boosters and it'll show you in the booster effects what it does for 10 turns.
But it'll actually use it up, right?
Yeah, yes. It uses up 10 of the resource.
Yeah.
But if you have a consistent income of them, then yeah, it can be a pretty decent buff.
Not a big deal to use it up if you got a lot of it.
Okay, I need to figure out where it is now. Right here. I have exactly 10, so... No.
Yeah, that's why the game's telling you.
Yeah, but I don't have a lot of it, I just have 10 of it.
Yeah, no, I know. The game is just mentioning that to you because it's probably the first time you've seen it.
Yeah, maybe.
And the game constantly reminds you that you haven't used your boosters.
Use the boost to get through.
Apparently in your next empire plan, don't put any influence into military. You set it to economy and population, and then I'll make these people happy.
Yeah, that'll come up in a few turns, probably.
Okay.
Basically, you're just proving to them that you're not a warmonger.
Ah, fat chance. You're going to need
like a warmonger? Never.
No. Let's see. Oh, there's a... I have a wonder I can make.
A wonder?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we've got to explain that. Under the science thing, did you see like the visionary leader, the wealth harvester, and the civilization builder thing?
No.
Yeah.
Oh, this
thing. Those are like age-specific things that you can do to get bonuses.
Okay.
Those can be very useful, and sometimes they're usually very useful, but sometimes they can just not really get much of anything, depending on what you're going for.
Apparently, my military sucks.
Don't cut the military, cut education.
The fuck? This guy had like billion science for one turn.